Everybody hear me okay? Nobody said anything, don't worry.
I hear my dad say that.
Okay.
Can you guys hear back there?
I think this is the first for me. I've never seen the groom have to track down the best man. It's usually the other way around, right? That's the best man's job. Alright, I'm Adam Waters, Justice of the Peace. I must say, it's really a pleasure being here. I was born and raised in Tucson, and for some reason I've never been here this late. So it's a special treat for me. Thank you. We are gathered here today to join in and celebrate the marriage of Adam and Angela. There's a big heavy sigh, Adam.
Feeling it now.
Sure. Those who enter into this relationship should not be so light. This is a covenant, a mutual commitment to love and care for each other, to bear each other's infirmities, to comfort the other, provide for each other in your home together and all that you're doing. Concern and respect for each other must be your daily goal. Adam, will you have Angela to be your lawfully wedded spouse in all faith and tenderness? To live with her and cherish her in the bond of marriage. Angela, will you have Adam to be your lawfully wedded spouse in all faith and tenderness, to live with him and cherish him in the bond of marriage? The bond of marriage, it's a promise, it's a vow. Under the law, it's a contract, but it's unlike any other contract we enter into because it's based on friendship, concern, and respect and love. We wanted to do a ceremony symbolizing your relationship. So we have water here somewhere. Is it in the cup?
Water.
Are you going to put earth in too? Angela explained that they picked a succulent because we live in the desert, obviously. And the symbolism of this ceremony is they're adding water and earth to represent their long-going standing love for each other. A future long-term relationship that will grow from
loving and faithful partner.
In good times and bad.
Good times and bad.
Enjoying sorrow.
In
health and sickness.
In health and sickness.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
I, Angela, take thee, Adam. To be my wedded spouse. And I do promise. Be your loving and faithful partner. Good times and bad, joy and sorrow, and health and sickness, for as long as we both shall live. I was going to read my poem this day. It's called Invitation. It doesn't interest me what you do for a living. I want to know what you ache for, and if you dare to dream of meeting your heart's longing. It doesn't interest me how old you are. I want to know if you'll risk looking like a fool for love, for your dream, for the adventure of being alive. It doesn't interest me what planets are squaring your moon. I want to know if you'll touch the center of your own sorrow, if you've been opened by life's betrayals or have become shriveled and closed from fear of further pain. I want to know if you can be with joy, mine or your own, if you can dance with wildness and let the ecstasy fill you to the tip of your fingers and toes, without crossing. Be careful, be realistic, to remember the limitations of being human. I want to know if you can see beauty, even when it is not pretty, every day. If you can source your own life from its presence. I want to know if you can stand with pain, yours and mine, and still stand at the edge of the lake, and shout to the silver of the full moon, yes. It doesn't interest me to know where you live or how much money you have. I want to know if you can get up after a night of grief and despair, weary and bruised to the bone, and do what needs to be done to feed the children. It doesn't interest me who you know or how you came to be here. I want to know if you are standing in the center of the fire. You told me you already have rings on. Do they symbolize and they show and tell everyone in a loving, committed relationship? May the two of you no longer think of yourselves as two, but rather as one, having promised to have respect, consideration, and love for each other forever. By the authority vested in me by the state of Arizona, and more importantly, because of the vows you made before your witnesses, I pronounce you husband and wife. Congratulations. Congratulations to you. And the hardest to say us, best wishes to you.
Thank you so much.
Oh, my pleasure. Congratulations. Step down and see everything. I'm glad you didn't have to say
that.
A lot of people don't do that part.
So I'm glad. All right.
Phones go up.
So.
Yeah, we'll just be. It's kind of comparable. Right? Well, smaller crowds.
Alright,
She realized we don't see Raina anymore. Why are you gonna miss Angela?
I was kind of worried.
Why is it still glowing?
Look, the ground is white. It's like ice.
No, ice,
Mama.
Thanks,
Mama.
Yes.
What's up?
I finally got over.
Take all this stuff down.
I'm going to be hard. I'm going to be hard.
There's the American.
Yeah, they keep trying to take me fishing on here one day. I don't like it. You said you had to be quiet and not talk. That was impossible.